you for this day that you have made, for us to rejoice and be glad in it. How beautiful are the feet of them that bring the gospel. Father, we pray this hour, this beautiful noontime, that the word of God will prevail over every dirty spirit in the name of Jesus. Father, we begin to release the power of God over this auditorium to silence contrary forces, to silence negative imaginations. Oh, the Bible says, casting down evil imaginations. And anything that wants to exalt itself against the knowledge of God, let it be brought low. Father, we bring low right now to total destruction. Any thoughts, any imagination, we bring it to captivity. That the word of God will prevail and must prevail. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we give you glory, Father, because you make your name great in our midst today. Take all your glory and your honor. As we humble ourselves, Lord, may you speak through us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we happy to be in his presence?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Joy, hallelujah, joy.
On veut un hallelujah avec joie. Hallelujah.
Amen. Let the light shine before the faces of the children of God.
Et que la lumière de Dieu brille sur la, le visage de ses enfants.
Because we serve a God of light.
Parce que nous servons un Dieu de lumière.
In him there is no darkness at all.
Et en lui, il n'y a pas d'obscurité.
Amen.
Amen.
I would like us to share the part two of the message, why every Christian should be a giver.
Et je veux que nous continuions maintenant dans la deuxième partie de notre message. Que pourquoi est-ce que tout chrétien doit être des donneurs, ceux qui font beaucoup de dons?
Amen.
Amen.
Why every Christian should be a giver?
Pourquoi tout chrétien doit donner?
We shared last time in 2 Corinthians 9, 7 to 8. We are not going to read this time.
Nous avons partagé dans le livre de 2 Corinthiens 9.
2 Corinthians chapter 9, 7 to 8.
2 Corinthiens 9, à partir du
7 to 8. It says, God loves a cheerful giver.
Et dans ce livre nous dit que Dieu aime les cœurs qui donnent avec charité.
That is our foundation. Every time I want to talk about giving in the house of God, I will never forget this scripture because God loves a cheerful giver, not the one that is forced to give.
Et à chaque fois que je vais prêcher, que je vais parler de donner, faire des dons dans la maison de Dieu, je vais toujours m'appuyer sur ce passage-là. Parce que ce passage nous instruit en nous disant que Dieu donne un cœur qui donne avec vraiment joie, avec vraiment charité. Amen.
Because when you give with joy, you go back with joy.
Parce que quand tu donnes avec joie, tu retournes à la maison avec joie.
But if you are forced to give, you go back with pain and grief.
Mais quand tu es forcé de pouvoir donner dans la maison de Dieu, tu retournes à la maison avec une peine dans le cœur.
It is not coming from your heart.
Cela ne vient pas de ton cœur.
You were put under pressure.
Tu as été, la pression était mise sur toi pour pouvoir donner.
So we are sharing the true foundation of what giving is.
Alors nous allons partager la
according to the lines of the scripture.
Nous allons partager la vraie fondation de donner avec charité selon,
according to the lines of the scripture. Amen. Because giving is a good thing and it is authorized by the Holy Scripture. So we are making a little bit of flashback for those that were not present in the first part of the
message.
There is a lot of misconceptions made in the house of God about giving because the man of God presented it for personal interest.
Il y a beaucoup d'incompréhensions dans la maison de Dieu selon le mot donner ou faire les dons à l'église parce que les hommes de Dieu, les servants de Dieu présentent cela sur eux-mêmes leur propre intérêt afin de pouvoir empocher ce qu'ils vont recevoir.
So plenty or many children of God today, if they just hear about giving in the church, they begin to calculate the time the service will close because they are not interested.
Parce que ce qui fait que beaucoup d'enfants de Dieu, quand ils écoutent, ils entendent dans l'église ou dans la maison de Dieu, on dit de venir donner, de venir faire des dons, ils commencent à calculer le temps que le service va pouvoir finir afin de pouvoir rentrer parce qu'ils veulent.
Why? Because they have been wrongly educated. by those who don't follow God but follow their personal interests and benefits.
Et pourquoi cela arrive aujourd'hui dans les églises? Parce qu'ils ont été mal éduqués, mal informés selon le mot donné fait les dons à l'église à cause des pasteurs et des hommes de Dieu qui ont mis cela au devant de pouvoir leur propre intérêt personnel.
Amen. We shared last time that giving is an expression of love and an obedience to the word of God.
Alors nous avons partagé la dernière fois que donner c'est une expression d'amour et une obéissance de la parole de Dieu.
Amen.
Amen.
If you love God, you will give because He first gave.
Et si tu aimes Dieu, tu vas donner parce que premièrement c'est lui qui a donné d'abord.
And if you love your God, you will also obey His commandments.
Et aussi si tu aimes ton Dieu, tu vas obéir à ce commandement.
And one of it is giving cheerfully. And that is our focus today. And don't forget cheerful giving.
Et ne oubliez pas donner avec charité.
Cheerful giving.
Donner avec charité.
Just like Dorcas did.
Comme Dorcas l'a fait.
And last time we said what? If you are a giver,
et la dernière fois qu'on a vu, si tu es donneur,
it will preserve your life.
Cela va préserver aussi ta vie.
If you are a giver,
si tu es quelqu'un qui donne,
it will defend you one day in the midst of trouble.
Cela va te défendre aussi un jour.
Your giving will save you.
Tes dons vont te sauver.
It is not good for a Christian.
C'est pas bon pour un chrétien.
To live a life of greediness, stinginess, and don't share.
C'est pas bon pour un chrétien de vivre une vie d'égoïsme, une vie vraiment de, je vais dire, c'est l'intérêt personnel.
Now, this giving we are talking about.
Maintenant, le don dont nous
parlons. Is it for some particular quality of Christians or for everybody?
Est-ce que cela concerne des chrétiens particuliers ou cela concerne tous les chrétiens?
It is not only for the pastor.
C'est pas seulement pour le pasteur.
It is not only for the workers.
C'est pas seulement pour les travailleurs.
And we bring the scriptures.
Je vais vous donner avec les.
That is why you will hear something about the widow's mite.
That's right. Widow's
mind. The widow's mind in the Bible.
Widow.
That is why you will hear the Bible say, God sent His servant to a poor widow. Why not a rich woman? The president's wife is there. The president is there. Why the poor widow? There is no qualification of who gives to God. As we are seated here, our capacities are not the same. So giving is not a form of competition. It is according to your heart and what you have. And the Lord receives it with joy and happiness. And we are blessed not according to the amount or the quantity that we give. But the cheerfulness of your heart, no matter what you lay before God, He is the multiplier. He multiplies it.
Mais à cause de la charité de ton cœur, selon ce que tu donnes, le Dieu qui multiplie, tu verras cela et il va multiplier cela.
Amen.
Amen.
Giving is living.
Et donner, c'est vivre.
If you want to be a vibrant Christian,
si tu veux être un chrétien vivant,
I'm showing you the hidden secrets of giving.
Je suis en train de maintenant.
Give us, never lack, and give us never
lack.
When you are a giving Christian,
it
doesn't matter the level of bitterness you find yourself, your God will make a way for you.
Amen.
I would like us to go to Ephesians 4, verse 28. Ephesians 4, 28.
Ephesians 4, 28. Are we there?
If we are there, please we say amen.
Amen.
So we make it easier.
Let him who stole steal no longer, but rather let him labor, walking on his hands. What is good, that he may have something to give him who has need.
Amen.
Amen.
Today I want us to talk about giving to the poor and the needy.
That's right.
Aujourd'hui, je veux que nous parlons de donner, faire des dons aux pauvres et faire des dons à ceux qui sont dans le besoin.
That's right.
Giving to the poor and the needy.
Donner à ceux qui sont dans le besoin et aux pauvres.
Now, I want us to remove the misconceptions about giving. and bring giving according to the truth of the scripture.
Alors maintenant, je veux que nous enlevons l'incompréhension de donner selon les formes. Et nous allons maintenant parler de, selon, de donner selon les écritures.
There are some preachers or teachers of the world who even encourage their Christians to do dirty things to get the kind of money they want from them. You will see boys carrying drugs, swallowing drugs. Pastor is praying for the church not to scatter in their stomach so they can deliver.
Amen.
Have you heard it?
Amen.
I am telling you.
Tout à l'heure, voir aussi des jeunes qui vont aller avaler la drogue et le pasteur va prier pour que la drogue ne se casse pas dans leur estomac. En fait, ils vont traverser la
drogue. So, il va deliver a great and good amount of money.
Ils vont vraiment aller accoucher la drogue là et vont cela ramener l'argent.
Look at my hands. This is not the kind of living I am talking about.
Et maintenant, je suis en train de parler. C'est pas ce genre de don. C'est pas ce genre de don que je parle dans la maison de Dieu. Non.
Those that are killing, they use murder to get money. And the pastor knows that they use murder to get money. And we encourage them and back them with whatever scripture only God knows. I don't know.
Ceux là qui vont tuer les gens pour pouvoir avoir de l'argent et venir à l'église et le pasteur prie pour eux. Je ne sais pas selon quelle parole de Dieu il dit pour prier pour eux et qu'il les encourage pour pouvoir venir donner dans la maison de Dieu.
Children of God, we are standing on the foundation of the blood of Jesus.
Peuple de Dieu, nous sommes vraiment sur la fondation du sang de Jésus.
And we are preaching the truth and nothing but the truth. And those that will know the truth shall set them free.
Amen.
28 of Ephesians 4 says, let him that stole steal no more. But rather let him labor. We are talking of the giving that comes from the work of your hands. Like when the pastor preached about, let me make a reference, about how we can be good managers of our finances.
Et je vais faire une petite référence sur ce que le pasteur a prêché pendant longtemps. Comment est-ce que nous pouvons bien manager nos finances?
He said, when you work,
il dit quand tu travailles,
you have to start in your house to take care of your family.
Tu dois commencer d'abord dans ta maison, non seulement de ta maison.
Before you look outside,
avant de commencer à chercher dans ta maison,
and see where you can extend your assistance for your help.
Et vois maintenant comment est-ce que tu peux maintenant élargir ton assistance, ton père, ce que tu peux mobiliser.
And that is why I also come here now.
Et c'est pour cela que je vais venir ici maintenant.
Working with his hands, the thing which is good, not the thing which is bad.
Mais plutôt qu'il travaille en faisant les semer, ce qui est bien, avoir de quoi à donner à celui qui est dans le besoin.
People of God, we have to work with our hands the thing that is good.
Mais Dieu, nous devons travailler avec nous-mêmes les choses qui sont bien.
You work with your hands and get the salary at the end of the month, or you work with your hands to get an instant payment. It is okay for God.
Où tu travailles avec ta main pour pouvoir avoir de l'argent à la fin du mois pour pouvoir venir et donner dans la maison de Dieu. Dieu est OK avec ça.
That they may have to give it to him that has need.
Right.
Afin de pouvoir donner à ceux-là qui sont dans le besoin.
Sometimes it bothers me.
De fois, je suis vraiment un peu.
When pastor said that who wants to receive the power of prosperity?
De fois, les pasteurs disent qui veut recevoir le pouvoir de la prospérité?
Is there any power of prosperity?
Est-ce qu'il y a le pouvoir de la
prospérité? The only secret for prosperity is hard work. That is what I know.
Hallelujah.
Giving the right services to the world and getting the money.
C'est travailler dur pour pouvoir recevoir cela.
Sister.
Amen.
Who is praying for a little down to him to get money?
Qui prie pour l'homme le plus
riche? The richest man in Africa. Who is praying for Bill Gates to make his money? Christians, let us be wise and let him that has ears hear what the Spirit says. So be prosperous and to be rich has to do with work and good thinking. I do not believe in the manipulation that today you are going to receive. Come and receive the power of prosperity. Which power?
Je ne crois pas ce genre de manipulation où les hommes de Dieu encouragent les fidèles pour leur dire, venez ne travaillez pas, je vais prier pour que vous puissiez avoir le pouvoir de la prospérité.
There is the power of transformation at the limit.
That
he can transform your bad thinking or getting money in a bad way, and you change it and get money in a good way. And think that. Because giving is a free will something. It doesn't have to do with force and coerce.
Ça n'a rien à voir avec la force.
So we work.
Donc nous devons travailler
to support.
Right.
We work.
Nous travaillons
to give.
Donner.
Because giving,
parce que donner
is living.
That's right.
Giving
donner
leads to a happy and a joyful Christian life.
Parce que donner vit d'abord donner aussi.
Because when you make that sister or that brother,
parce que quand tu
wear a shoe that is not torn,
that's right,
or a trouser that is not torn,
ou qui a une chaussure qui n'est pas normale ou un pantalon qui n'est pas normal,
you have so much joy in that life.
Tu lui donnes de l'argent.
And when you see her coming with joy,
tu viens de lui donner la
joie. Your heart smiles.
Et quand tu la vois, et quand tu le vois, on est parti avec la joie. Tu dis toi aussi tu as de la joie parce que tu as fait une bonne œuvre.
Mais today,
mais aujourd'hui,
church,
église,
is really a question.
C'est vraiment une question.
You will come to church.
Tu vas venir à l'église.
You see Sister Mary.
Tu vas voir Sister Mary.
The hips of her shoe is, you know, the only thing you are doing. This is what we see today.
Mais c'est ce que nous voyons dans les églises, c'est dommage.
We come in church,
nous venons à l'église.
We laugh at our brothers and our sisters.
Nous nous moquons de nos frères et sœurs.
Whereas,
or pourtant,
we are in the position.
Nous sommes dans la position
to support him or her.
Pour les supporter financièrement, pour les aider.
It is sad.
C'est vraiment triste.
It is sad.
C'est vraiment triste.
Because you are capable.
Parce que tu es capable.
I am capable.
Et je suis aussi capable.
We can make that brother or that sister better. But today, the Christianity of today,
la vie de
we need to change.
Nous avons besoin de changer.
Because to see the power of God in our midst, we have to make sure these things work out well.
Nous devons vraiment nous assurer que tout se passe bien au milieu de nous, nos frères et
sœurs. Amen.
Amen.
In Matthew 25, 31 to 46.
Dans le livre de Matthieu
25, 31 to 46.
31 à
Jesus will ask.
Jésus a demandé.
When I ask you for water, you did not give me.
Quand je t'ai demandé de l'eau, est-ce que tu m'as donné l'eau?
I ask for food, you did not give me.
Je t'ai demandé d'argent.
Let us look at the scripture.
Okay. I read. When the Son of Man comes in His glory and all the holy angels with Him, then He will sit on the throne of His glory. All the nations will gather before Him, and He will separate them one from another, as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goat. And He will set the sheep on His right hand, but the goat on the left. Then the King will say to those on His right hand, come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was stranger, and you took me in. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me. Then the righteous would answer him, saying, Lord, when did I see you hungry and feed you, and thirsty, give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and take you in, or naked and clothe you? Or when did we see you sick or in prison and come to you? And the King will answer and say to them, I say to you, inasmuch as you did it to one of the least of these my brethren, you did it to me. Then he will also say to those on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you did not take me in. Naked, and you did not clothe me. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they also will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry, or thirsty, a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister to you? Then he will answer them, saying, as surely I say to you, as much as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into eternal life.
Amen. Hallelujah. Did we get something from here? Time is not in our favor, then let us just be attentive. The sheep has to do with the obedient ones. They are the obedient ones. When they saw the needy and the poor, they attended to them. They didn't know they were doing it for the Lord. Get the lesson. And those on the left, they rejected the poor. They didn't know they had rejected Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And when the Lord came, and he began to tell them, when I was naked or in prison, you didn't attend to me. And Christians who serve the Lord with the eyes of the head, not the eyes of the spirit, they begin to ask, when?
Because
they were expecting to see a giant figure. But you don't know that that little sister beside you and that little brother beside you represents Christ.
That's right.
When you put smile on his face or her face,
that's right.
In the day of tribulation, the reality of the gospel is obedience and doing what the Lord has asked us to do.
La réalité de la prédication ou de l'évangile, c'est d'obéir à ce que le Seigneur nous demande de faire.
Giving does not have to do with the rich, it has to do with everyone who believes in Christ.
Et donner n'a rien à voir seulement avec les riches, mais ça a à voir avec tous ceux qui se disent.
Because God does not want to bless also, he does not only bless only the rich, he blesses both the rich and the poor. There is no qualification in giving.
Il n'y a pas de qualification pour pouvoir donner.
Giving brings multiplication.
Et donner plus, donner envoie la multiplication.
When the widow gave the last piece of flour that she had to Elijah, and she wanted to prepare that and die because everything was finished. And he was looking how the people were giving offering.
Et Jésus aussi était là, il était en train de regarder le jour où les gens étaient en train de faire les offrandes. Il regardait comment est-ce que les gens.
He saw how the widow came out with two mites and dropped it in the offering basket.
Et il a vu aussi une veuve qui est venue avec deux petites pierres qui a donné de l'argent pour le panier.
She has given more.
Et il a dit à ses disciples, elle a, c'est elle qui a donné le plus.
And the widow's mind is just like, how much we put it in this?
Like 2 cents,
very little one.
So if
you are in the house and it is offering time, you have a sense. It is not you. If your heart is willing, giving, God will put the multiplication. It's not a form of competition at all. It is an act of obedience. Let us feel free in the house of God.
Absolutely.
And do according to His will. And we will be blessed.
Amen. Amen.
Solomon, in the midst of confusion, offered 1,000 rams to God.
Il a offert plus de 1,000 béliers à Dieu.
God visited him the same night.
Dieu l'a visité cette
nuit. So I will tell you, if you are a giver,
alors je vais te dire,
you will compare godly visitation.
Tu vas recevoir une visite divine de ton Dieu.
Right. Amen.
Amen.
And that which you have not even asked in your prayer, the Lord will give it to you.
Mais ce que tu n'as pas demandé dans ta prière, ton Dieu
l'a donné. Let us learn to give and give liberally.
That's
right. For a liberal son shall be made fat.
Quelqu'un qui donne librement au
fils. And he that waters shall be watered also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Lord bless this word. And we pray him for another opportunity.
God
bless us. Amen.